On the Channel 13 News at 10, our Jody Long uncovered things we never knew about the state's child abuse registry, how Iowans end up on it, and how few people have access to that list. Jody is continuing our coverage this evening on the topic, and wow, you got a lot of people talking about this.
Yeah, Dan, now people are asking if they can't have access to the registry, how can they help keep their kids safe from potential future harm?
Yes, I mean, it is problematic in many ways.
Iowa Legal Aid isn't the only one with something to say about Iowa's child abuse registry. Dozens of Iowans are sounding off on the WHOHD Facebook page. Ray Smith says she has zero faith in any Iowa department that deals with child abuse after the deaths of Sabrina Ray and Natalie Finn. One woman claims she's on the abuse registry, but never abused her kids. She says it's preventing her from getting a job. Others are coming to the Department of Human Services defense, like Sasha Jackson, who applauds DHS for taking her adoptive daughter out of an abusive home. Nearly 50,000 Iowans are listed on the child abuse registry. Just last year, a little more than 3,000 people were added after DHS investigated 33,000 cases.
Any process that does not involve, you know, as a core part of the process, access to counsel, access to good information, I think is fundamentally flawed.
Alex Cornia with Iowa Legal Aid explains the child abuse registry as a civil process, not a criminal matter. Since offenders are not given the right to an attorney in child abuse registry cases, Cornia says that's one of the main reasons the public has extremely limited access to it.
The registry is not enough to make sure that children are safe. You know, there are a wide variety of tools actually at the disposal of both private parties and the state.
If Iowans don't fall under the state's guidelines to access the registry, lawyers recommend filing a complaint to policymakers to change who is granted access to the registry. Those who are concerned about their child's safety can also file for a sexual abuse civil protective order. It allows for a judge to implement a protective order before the arrest of a suspect.
Now, for those who do have access to the registry, like a daycare provider, they cannot share their findings with anyone else, or they could face jail time, the law states. The only other way for someone to gain access to information that's on the registry is if an alleged offender shares that information freely, Dan.
Okay, yeah, because that's likely to happen, right?
Right.
Thanks, Jody.